Let's take a look at the symptoms of hip arthritis and how they affect your daily life.
The symptoms of hip osteoarthritis are pain, primarily pain which can be associated with getting up from a seated position, pain associated with getting up out of bed and starting to walk in the morning. A lot of times you'll have pain going up and down stairs. And then secondarily, you can start to have limitations in motion of the hip. It gets harder to get up from a seated position. And sometimes you can wind up with some shortening of the leg of the extremity as a result of the joint wearing down, and then you can start to walk with a limp sometimes. As the hip socket continues to wear down and there's not much cartilage left in the hip socket, even if you're not weight-bearing on the hip, you can still have pain because the bones are rubbing against each other. And just changing position, whether it's in bed or changing position to get out of bed or sitting in a chair, getting up from a seated position can be rather uncomfortable. When the hip starts to wear down, a lot of the pain is generated in the groin, in the front of the hip, as opposed to the side or in the back. And sometimes because of how the nervous system is set up, you can have some pain that's referred to the inside of the knee. So every now and then we'll see someone come in and say they have pain in the knee, and it actually turns out to be a bad hip socket. As a rule, the pain generated from a bad hip socket is going to be in the front. We're looking for the degree that there may be a loss of motion. That the more arthritic the hip becomes, the more loss of motion they have. The tissues around the socket start to contract from disuse, and that limits the function and the movement of the hip. We look to see if there's shortening of the leg associated with loss of cartilage in the hip joint. Are they limping? Are they having back problems which have developed secondarily to try to keep limping on a bad hip socket? And how easy is it to reproduce the pain in the hip socket? If we rotate the leg inwards and it gives them excruciating pain, we know that we have a problem that's not going to easily be dealt with pills or injections or therapy. How far you can walk, what intensifies the pain, what kind of things aren't you able to do anymore, are you tired of the pain? Because that's a big determinant in what you do. Can you continue to tolerate what you're experiencing on a daily basis, or is the problem big enough to do something about it? Terry has come into the office for evaluation of pain he's experiencing in the hip. And one of the first things that we're going to do is check the motion in the hip joint, see if there's any limitation that we're seeing, which may be associated with the development of osteoarthritis. And one of the first things that we can check is the range of motion in your hip socket here. And one of the first things that we assess is the ability of the leg to rotate inwards, which is often limited in the osteoarthritic hip. We check the ability to rotate outwards as well. And then we check the ability to extend the knee here, and if there's any reproduction of pain going down the leg or in the hip region when we do that. We also can check the strength of the musculature, which may be an indication of if the muscles around the hip joint are properly working. If you could push out against my hand, Terry, and then press back down. There you go. And why don't you lie down here for a second, Terry? The other thing that we want to check here is the range of motion in a different fashion here. We bring the hip up to 90 degrees and then internally rotate the leg to see if that generates pain in the hip socket. Oftentimes with an arthritic hip, that will. And the ability to rotate the leg outward is also assessed. We can assess some degree of the function of the musculature if we slightly rotate the leg out and bring that into extension. Sometimes we can feel muscles or tendons popping over the bony prominences around the hip, indicating that there's a muscular problem contributing to the patient's discomfort. You can also palpate or feel the tissues where some of the muscles attach to the top of the femur bone here to see if they're reproducing any pain around the hip. Generally, the pain from an osteoarthritic worn down hip is going to be more centralized in the groin. In younger people, you see people with an osteoarthritic hip from trauma. They may be in a car accident. They may hit their knee against the dashboard, cause some damage to the cartilage on the end of the bone, which then develops into an arthritic hip. Later on in life, in your 60s and your 70s and your 80s, you can have wear and tear that's associated with progressive degenerative changes, progressive osteoarthritis. The most common scenario would be the slow progression of deterioration of the hip socket from osteoarthritis. The next thing that we would want to do with Terry is check x-rays. Because on the x-rays, we'll see if there's a loss of joint space associated with wear and tear. We'll see if there's bone spurs forming around the hip. We'll see if there's any calcification in the tissues around the hip socket. We'll make sure there aren't any type of lesions within the bone. That could be a reason or an explanation for the pain, and see how much of this may be attributed to osteoarthritis.
Here we have the front view of a gentleman who was having pain in his right hip. This is his right hip. This is his left hip. Here we see on his normal left hip, this is the middle of the ball, and this is the outer surface of the ball. This is the surface of the socket. So here we see a good space between the ball and the socket, this space in here. On his painful arthritic hip, here is the middle of the ball, and here is the periphery of the collapsed surface of the ball. It's all worn down with bone spurs like this, and the socket that's also all worn down and collapsed on the ball. This is the same gentleman who's now undergone a hip replacement. Again, on the left side, middle of the ball, a normal ball and a normal socket. On the right side, where he has undergone a hip replacement, we have this metal ball that's connected to a metal stem that is inside the bone. The metal stem connected to the metal ball that is then sitting inside this metal socket.